Hey everyone, and welcome to Boston Auto Blog. We take a look at pricing for compact crossovers in 2021. They become pretty expensive, especially on the high end. When you start looking at spending around $35,000 to $40,000 for a well-equipped model, you have to start asking yourself, is it worth paying this price? Because at around $40,000, you're now into luxury crossover territory. Well, a lot of buyers are now starting to look at the mid-size crossover market, which is a bit more upscale and also has a price point that overlaps the compact crossover market. Because at around $40,000, you can receive a lot of value. You can get a lot of features, you can get some great comfort, you can also get better performance. And that's why I am here to take a look at the 2021 Nissan Murano, because the Murano competes in a very highly contested market where vehicles like the Honda Passport, Chevrolet Blazer, Ford Edge, and Hyundai Santa Fe have become very appealing to Americans as they fit their lifestyles, as they're bigger vehicles, more spacious on the interior, and also more practical. And I am here to see if the Murano provides all of those characteristics. Now, believe it or not, the Nissan Murano has been with us for quite some time, being part of the first wave of midsize crossovers to hit the market back in around 2005. Today, this segment has grown substantially with new additions like the Honda Passport and Chevrolet Blazer. But in that time, Nissan has been very successful with this vehicle, and today I'm going to find out why. So in this video, we're going to take a good long look at the Nissan Murano Platinum, see how it compares to other vehicles in its segment, and if you're looking to buy a compact crossover that's priced around $35,000 to $40,000, then maybe looking at a midsize crossover, specifically the Murano, might be a great decision. Now before we get in this video, I want to give a huge shout out and thank you to Boch Nissan in Norwood, Massachusetts, for allowing me to do this review. Their link will be in the description below, so you can check out their extensive Nissan inventory. And so, without wasting any further time, let's get right in this review. Growing in popularity with consumers from a wide range of demographics, midsize crossovers bring styling and driving characteristics that differ quite a bit from the more affordable compacts that average Americans just can't get enough of. This includes more powerful engines, a striking road presence, and for newer models, better technology, comfort features, and overall refinement. The Nissan Murano embodies most of these attributes, being seen as a fun and upscale vehicle compared to the Rogue, while also being relatively affordable. In an ever-changing automotive industry, the Murano finds itself as being one of the older models in this segment, with a refresh presumably coming down the road. But the real question is whether the 2021 Murano still holds up against the competition, and if it's truly worth paying more compared to a compact crossover. Starting off with pricing, the Nissan Murano Platinum comes in at $45,910, which is about $7,000 more than a top trim Rogue. While Nissan has fared well in the midsize crossover segment, pricing has played a role in buyers being hesitant to upgrade, as the Rogue offers better practicality and cargo space behind the second row seats. More often than not, consumers will likely choose an SV or SL to save money, and still receive a good amount of comfort and luxury features that the Rogue may not offer. However, when looking at exterior dimensions, the Murano may be appealing to buyers with growing families, as this crossover is 10 inches longer and 3 inches wider than the Rogue, and in turn, this will have a profound effect on overall interior room for all occupants inside. For drivers looking at some light off-road capability, the Murano will have 6.9 inches of ground clearance, which should be adequate for dirt roads and unplowed streets during the winter. Taking a glance at the road presence, the third generation Nissan Rogue builds off the designs from prior model years, having similar body lines and angles. However, this time around, being far more athletic and aggressive. Within the crossover lineup for Nissan, you can start to see how this model is beginning to age, as its design has been with us since 2014, and most likely we'll be seeing a major overhaul in the near future. The lighter body color on our model helps accentuate the V-Motion grille, with a mixture of chrome and gloss black accents that integrate quite well with the LED headlights. And while we can only imagine what a next generation Murano would look like, the lack of a boxy design still gives this vehicle an appealing appearance. Moving over to the side profile, the Murano Platinum will be sitting on 20-inch dark hyper silver aluminum alloy wheels. And thanks to the lack of plastic cladding, these wheels certainly grab attention. You'll have body color folding side mirrors with turn signal indicators. to go along with blind spot detection for added safety. Then coming around to the back, where the Murano distinguishes itself from the rest of the lineup is with the sloping roofline that differs greatly from the boxier Rogue and Pathfinder. And this is common among two-row midsize crossovers that either bring a sporty or luxurious vibe. Standing out on our model is the gloss black rear spoiler, and of course, the dual exhaust outlets. And for the upscale look, the Murano will have LED taillights to complete the overall appearance. Under the hood, the Nissan Murano is powered by a 3.5-liter V6 engine that puts out 260 horsepower and 240 pound-feet of torque, and is paired with a CVT. While you won't have a traditional automatic, the V6 alone is going to offer a unique driving experience, as many rivals have gone down the path of turbocharged 4-cylinder engines, which obviously are going to be more efficient and provide decent performance, but the V6 is a dying breed, and when accelerating, you can't help but smile despite this crossover not being all that sporty. For the drivetrain, front-wheel drive does come standard, even for the Platinum, with all-wheel drive being a $1,500 option. For fuel economy, you'd expect to receive right around 20 miles per gallon in the city, and 28 miles per gallon on the highway. Stepping inside, you get power-adjustable, heated and ventilated leather seats, with diamond quilted inserts, for both the driver and passenger. And our model has the classy mocha brown leather, which contrasts very nicely with the wood grain trim. If you're cross-shopping a Rogue and Murano, you'll first notice a more plush and upscale interior, despite the Murano getting up there in age compared to the recently refreshed Rogue. While the dashboard layout and molding isn't the most up-to-date, the Murano is still going to have a welcoming driving environment. In front of you, between the analog gauges, you will have a digital display that's commonly used in Nissan and Infiniti products. And while this isn't a full digital gauge cluster like we find in the Rogue Platinum, resolution and quality are impressive, and it's here where you can scroll through a variety of information. And with the Platinum trim, you will have traffic sign recognition to make up for the lack of a head-up display for this generation. Moving over to the infotainment system, you'll have an 8-inch touchscreen with Apple CarPlay and Android Auto compatibility, to go along with onboard navigation and the 11-speaker Bose Premium Audio System. For buyers looking for a more analog dashboard design, they're going to enjoy the physical buttons that quickly get you to different menus, to go along with the volume and tuning knobs. One feature we don't normally see anymore is the CD player, which is mounted just above the screen. As you can tell, the head unit for the Murano hasn't been facelifted yet, like we've seen with the Nissan Rogue, so it does show its age. However, this user interface does respond quite well. As always, you will have a backup camera with trajectory, but with the Platinum, you will have additional angles to view to help make parking the Murano much easier. Below, you'll find the buttons for the dual zone climate control, AC, and front and rear defrosters. And as we work our way down towards the center console, there will be a 12-volt outlet and a USB and USB-C input for smartphone connectivity. Then next to the gear shifter, you'll have a small cubby for your key fob. And closer to the driver's side, are two small dials for the three-level heated and ventilated seats. Then for the center storage compartment, there's plenty of room for small items, and you can easily fit a couple of water bottles here for sure. And rounding out the front seating area, above will be a dual-pane panoramic moonroof to let in a lot of natural light to brighten up the interior. Now for passengers in the back, we're going to start off on the passenger side, and the seat is adjusted further back. It's also somewhat on a recline, and I have plenty of legroom to work with here, which is something we don't see a lot for compact crossovers, which is why you want to upgrade to a midsize. Now, there's a few things that I want to point out here. Now, first off, I am 5'5", so I'm not the tallest person out there, but I do think if you're on the height of 5'8", 5'9", you could sit back here pretty comfortably for sure, and also most likely this seat is not going to be adjusted this far back. So if you have someone around the height of 6 feet tall in front of you, and you have someone of my height in the second row, we're all going to be pretty comfortable for sure. But also when it comes to these second row seats, they do sit pretty low to the ground, so it maximizes headroom. And when it comes to that headroom, you have plenty of it, even with this massive panoramic moonroof. So for tall passengers, they're not going to be claustrophobic in any way. Now, for the center seat, the center hump is not aggressive at all. In fact, it's not even existent. So theoretically, you could fit three average-sized adults back here for sure. definitely kids. When it comes to shoulder room, it's not that bad. It's a bit wider than compact crossovers. So I think when it comes to the family-friendly aspect, the Murano is definitely more suitable for that growing family, and I think it's a nice upgrade over a compact crossover. So when it comes to the comfort aspect, especially with these leather seats, also legroom, shoulder room, it's pretty nice in here for sure. And then on the driver's side, the seat is adjusted to someone of my head around 5'5", and I have plenty of legroom to work with here. So I think overall, the Nissan Murano is a nice upgrade if you are looking to trade up from your Nissan Rogue or Toyota RAV4 Honda CR-V. And I think you're gonna like the fact that this vehicle is family friendly, it's spacious, but also it's a lot more upscale. Also back here, you will have two level heated outboard seats, a USB and USB-C input to go along with two rear air vents. And rounding out the rear seating area, you do get a center armrest with two cup holders. Now coming around to the back, you're going to receive a power lift gate. And inside, you're gonna find right around 32.1 cubic feet of rear cargo space, which is pretty typical for most crossovers in this segment. Now you're probably wondering, why does it only have 32 cubic feet of room if the Murano is a bigger vehicle than the Rogue? And it really just comes down to the fact that the Murano has a sloping roofline, so it's more sportier, it has more of that aggressive styling, but we see this a lot in this market, where vehicles like the Chevrolet Blazer and Ford Edge aren't necessarily more practical than a Ford Escape or Chevrolet Equinox, but they provide overall value when it comes to interior quality, refinement, and also when it comes to performance as well. And the same goes for the Nissan Murano. So even though it's not going to have a higher roofline, you'll still be able to fit a lot of items back here. I would say 3 to 4 bags of luggage if you are going on a road trip with the family. Then with the second row seats folded, that space is going to double in size to around 68 cubic feet. So overall, what you're getting here is a practical crossover that's more spacious than compact crossovers overall. And also, it's more versatile for sure for a growing family. It just has a little more of that luxury factor. It's a more upscale, and you're not going to lose the practicality when it comes to cargo space. Then on either side of the rear cargo area, you will have quick release levers that will conveniently lower those second row seats. So you won't be wasting time manually lowering them. You can just load up your Murano and be on your way for your next adventure. Then beneath the floor mat, you're gonna find a spare tire, which if you do encounter a flat on your journeys or travels, you can fix that and be back on the road. Also back here, you will have a rear cargo cover, which will keep all your valuable items out of sight. So if you are like me and you have camera gear with you or have anything of value, you can leave them back here and you'll have that peace of mind knowing that no one will be able to peek in and steal what you have. And then once you're done, just press the button and the lift gate will close automatically. All right, so let's take the Nissan Murano out for a test ride to see how it performs, how it handles, how it drives, and how it compares to the Nissan Rogue, and if it is worth paying extra for this vehicle. Now, right off the bat, before we even leave the dealership, I gotta be honest, the interior is very premium. In fact, there's some bits and pieces that remind me of the Infiniti QX55 that I recently reviewed. The materials are a little more upscale, which is to be expected. I mean, Nissan is not going to make the Murano cheaper on the inside compared to the Rogue, but it feels really nice in here. I'm also interested in seeing how the V6 compares to the four-cylinder in the Rogue and how it pairs with the CVT. So let's get a quick acceleration in here. Not bad at all. The power is a lot better for sure compared to the Rogue. You can get the speed pretty quickly. Now, in terms of driving dynamics and handling, it feels pretty smooth for sure. And what I really can appreciate is, again, with the CVT, it mimics the gear shifts really well. And that's one thing I do like about the CVTs that are found in Nissans and Infinities, because a lot of brands, especially Japanese brands, they have the CVTs and you get that droning, you don't really get the quick shifting, and it just really ruins the driving experience. Also, when it comes to front vision, you have plenty of it. A-pillars are somewhat aggressive. However, the side mirrors are pretty big, so you can see a lot to your sides and your blind spots. So I definitely like that. Also, when it comes to seating position, you sit pretty high up. you sit a lot higher up compared to the Rogue. So you have a much better vision in front of you. And also the hood isn't that bad at all. It does slope a bit so you can see what's in front of you. There's a lot of vision to work with here. Also, when it comes to interior space, of course it's going to be bigger than the Rogue. You have a lot of shoulder room. And really, this feels like a significantly larger crossover compared to the Rogue. Now, as I mentioned during the beginning of this video, this particular segment has a great variety where there is some individualism with different vehicles. So, of course, you're going to have the Chevrolet Blazer and the Ford Edge ST, which is more the sportier side of things for the midsize crossover segment. You also have the Passport, which is more that rugged feel. It's a two-row version of the Pilot. And Nissan took a more luxury approach. This is actually like a nice middle ground for the brand, where it's not an Infiniti, but it kind of feels like one on the inside. Now, with the Nissan Murano, what you are going to notice is that it definitely leans more towards the luxury side of things rather than sporty. And a lot of brands right now are going with the sports crossover trend, and some people don't like that, especially where if you are not an enthusiast, most likely you're not going to want paddle shifters. You're not really going to care about the performance aspect in that regard, you know, going 0 to 60 around 5 or 4 seconds. The Nissan Murano is a nice mid-level vehicle that you can save a bit and still receive a lot of value. So you're not spending the money that you're going to find in an Acura or Lexus product, or even if you go upscale with Infiniti. You're going to get a vehicle at around $40,000, $45,000 that is going to provide that plush experience. It's going to give you that comfort that you expect at this price range. Now, some people will argue that because a Nissan Rogue has been updated recently, you're going to get more technology features. You're going to have the head-up display. You have a full digital gauge cluster. However, with the full digital gauge cluster, you're spending around $40,000. So you still have to spend a lot of money for the Platinum with the Rogue. Whereas with the Murano, even if you don't have that technology aspect, you're still going to get that plush experience, get that entry-level luxury feel. And you don't necessarily need to spend $45,000 for the Platinum. You can obviously go with an SV, go with the additional packages, and you're going to receive a lot of value at that price point. So I definitely understand why Nissan has consistently done well with this vehicle throughout the years, because it's that nice blend and balance of being affordable while also being luxurious and comfortable. Now, by going with the Platinum, you're also going to have ventilated seats, which on a very warm day like today is very nice. And once again, paired with these leather seats, it's a comfortable experience. It's like sitting on a cloud. And now I understand, because I was very hesitant. I'm like, why would I spend extra for the Murano compared to the Rogue, especially where the Murano is a two-row crossover? Why is it worth paying an extra $5,000? And this right here is why. It's more comfortable, it's more upscale, it's certainly more plush, and it is worth the price for sure. Also, with the V6, you get more power. So you have more power to work with, and the driving experience is a bit more engaging, because with the Rogue, I wish we had a more powerful engine. I wish there was more than just 181 horsepower. However, with the Murano, we have 260 horsepower, and it's definitely enough for sure, especially for drivers who are not looking to speed on the highway and, you know, really break speed records. This is a great vehicle for those consumers. So after this test drive, would I recommend taking a look at the Murano over the Rogue? And as I always say, test drive them both, cross shop them, see which one fits your lifestyle the best. Because if you have a budget around $40,000, I would take a look at the Murano SL for sure over the Rogue Platinum. Even though you are sacrificing a bit when it comes to technology, if you don't really care about technology, then I think you're going to like the Murano just because it's a little more luxurious. But also when it comes to the driving dynamics, handling, and just the overall refinement, the Murano is definitely the better way to go. Also, and as I said walking into this vehicle, why is it worth paying extra for the Murano? And this right here is why. It's more luxurious. You have a better engine under the hood. It pairs very well with the CVT. Also, I think when it comes to just the overall value that you have here, it's certainly a step up for sure. And also, when you're looking at luxury crossovers from Lexus, Acura, even Infiniti, you might be paying a lot more for the same features or paying for a similar package. So I would definitely say that the Murano is certainly worth the price, especially for a Platinum under $50,000. That's not bad. So if you're looking for that mid-range, you're looking for that mid-range crossover that you're not going to break the bank on, and you don't really necessarily care about technology, then take a look at the Murano. So at the end of the day, what are my final thoughts for the Nissan Murano? And I gotta be honest, I'm pretty impressed with this vehicle, even though it is getting up there in age for this particular generation. The interior quality and comfort is definitely a step up over the Nissan Rogue, and that's to be expected just because the Rogue is not going to be an entry-level luxury crossover, although I did like the interior materials that was used even for the SV. Now, when it comes to these seats, though, they are plush. It's like sitting on a cloud. And it makes you feel as though that you are in an entry-level luxury vehicle, especially like an Infiniti or a Lexus or an Acura. And that's why I think Nissan has done a relatively great job with this vehicle throughout the years when it comes to sales, just because I think most consumers are willing to upgrade to a slightly bigger vehicle that's more family-friendly, but also more luxurious as well. Then when it comes to performance, I absolutely love the V6 under the hood. It gives you that old school SUV vibe that we just don't see anymore in the automotive industry, just because a lot of brands are now going to turbocharged four cylinder engines. So when it comes to that aspect, I think consumers are going to like the Murano for sure. Then when it comes to the CVT, of course, a lot of consumers want to have a true automatic, but the CVT mimics the gear shifts very well. But I would like to see a true automatic in the future for the next generation, like we are going to see with the Pathfinder. But I think that when you are cross-shopping the Rogue and the Murano, and most likely you're not going to cross-shop a Platinum for a Platinum, but I think that when you're looking at the price points and you're like, is it worth paying an extra $5,000 or $7,000 for the Murano? I think it is. Even if you don't go with a Platinum and you're going to go with an SL, I think you're still receiving a lot of value for the price. And that's why I think that this vehicle is still performing very well when it comes to sales. Why Americans are looking at vehicles in this segment, because they provide more comfort. They provide better overall refinement. They provide better driving characteristics and performance. And with the Murano, it's no different. You're going to have a better driving feel compared to the Rogue or a RAV4 or a CRV. And if you are looking to make that upgrade where you need to have more space for that growing family, then the Murano is definitely the way to go. So guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe for more. Also, make sure to follow me on Instagram at Boston Auto Blog, so you can see what I'm up to and what vehicles I'll be featuring in the future. And I will see you guys next time.